Hey, Joel Punk Race Restorations. We're sitting inside the 1971 Dodge Dart. As you can see, it's coming along quite well. We've got the dash reassembled on the car, pending a few little wiring items needed. Got all the wiring buttoned up in there, and it's actually a nice, clean, custom look for the dash. We do have an aftermarket steering wheel for the car, but the installation kit that was supplied unfortunately does not fit the steering column, so we're going to have to look at other options on that. Okay, as you can see, we've got our door panels and rear interior panels recovered and installed. Very nice, clean, smooth look on there. We've made our adjustments on the rear quarter windows, so they function quite well. They go up and down, and no dragging issues there. The stereo, all the switches on the dash, everything's been tested, and the functionality's really good on everything. Our glove box is installed. We've got our trunk popper there for the trunk release. Okay, we also have our Be Quiet sound deadening material down on the floor. This product is really good for sound deadening, and it's thinner than some of the other sound deadening material products on the market, so you don't get a lot of additional weight on the car with this. Okay, headlights, everything has been wired up, tested, and got the seal of approval. The engine is coming together as well. This is a custom build on the engine, and we had to order in custom push rods to correct the geometry for the valve train and get the proper length and clearance we need for the aftermarket out of rock heads. Okay, the engine has a full roller valve train set up, so a lot of movement in the valve train on this one. Okay, one issue we did run into on the engine was the adjusting locking bolts for the rocker arms were previously Loctited with a liquid thread lock, and that's a no-no. So once we get those corrected, we'll get those reinstalled into the rocker arms, and then we can continue on with the engine build for the 360. Once the engine's completed, we'll get the wiring ran into its designated location and get all that wrapped up nice and neat. You can see we've got our steering coupler installed. It's a nice clean look down there. And hopefully real soon we'll be able to start the engine up and do the break-in procedure so we can hear this thing run. This car is coming close to completion, and we'll keep everybody up to date on videos as progress comes along.